We get to sit in this really nice theater. Sarah Fang, she oversees the Doris Duke Theatre. Thanks for having us down again. This is really nice to be back.
No, thank you for being here. I mean, it's really nice to have people back. So the Doris Duke Theatre, we're a part of the Honolulu Museum of Art, and we're really its gathering place. We showcase art house films, lectures, performances, film festivals, and we're really looking forward to welcoming everyone back, as well as creating deeper ties to the exhibitions in our galleries. For these past 2.5 years, you know, these seats have just been so empty, so it was so nice to reopen earlier this month.
There's no dust on them, so that's a good sign.
It's
a good sign.
You guys have
kept it clean, and it really looks nice, and I'm sure that everybody's excited about coming back down through here and watching.
No, yeah, and we're so excited to have them back. Our opening event this month was a really great panel and poetry reading called Caring Culture, mm-hmm. E Ola Ikavai. We invited all these amazing poets with backgrounds from all over Oceania to talk about the importance of water and sharing their art and poetry, and the theater lit up. It was just so wonderful to have this wonderful energy again back here.
You know, since you do oversee it, I like that what you just said, because it does come alive, doesn't it? When there's somebody in the seats, when there's something that's interesting being played, this place does come alive. Maybe you can talk about that a little bit.
You know, the pandemic really kind of siloed everyone, and everyone started watching things at home, but I am a true believer in the collective experience of cinema and experience a live performance together. And so it's really that energy that we really want to share with everyone and to have people experience here.
An energy that can be shared throughout the entire month of October. Can you let us know what's on the agenda?
You know, in planning for the reopening, I felt like it was really important to center this theater in the place that we are and center ourselves in Oceania. So a lot of the programming this month is of Hawaii and about Hawaii. And we have a lot of really great films coming up, including a new feature by Christopher Makoto Yogi, local filmmaker, mm-hmm. called I Was a Simple Man, that had its run a little bit earlier in 2021, but you know, because of the pandemic, I don't think it really saw the run it needed. So I was really excited to bring that back. Another film we have this month is called Cane Fire. It's a really great documentary by filmmaker Anthony Banua Simon that really takes a look through his family's history on Kauai and how Kauai has been, and Hawaii in general, has been portrayed in Hollywood cinema and everything that comes with it and all the inaccuracies perhaps. Mm-hmm. But you know, Hawaii is always marketed as this paradise, especially in cinema, and that film Cane Fire really just takes a really critical look at it. And another film we have this month is a very experimental documentary.
Ooh, do tell.
Yes, it's called Rock Bottom Riser. And it is a film by artist Fern Silva. And so he's Portuguese. He really takes a good look at Hawaii. He was inspired by all the protectors of Mauna Kea and everything that was happening around the TMT to come and shoot. And he's got very amazing footage. And what he does is kind of just lays it there. He just kind of gives you there. He doesn't push an opinion on you. He kind of lets you make it up on your own. And so I really enjoyed this film.
The October agenda laid out for us all. Any future plans for this theater now that it's back up and running full speed ahead?
This weekend, we're really excited to be the venue for the 33rd annual Honolulu Rainbow Film Festival. They've been a longtime partner. We're really excited to bring worldwide LGBTQ films here during Honolulu Pride Month. We're starting definitely with the love of cinema, but we're also excited to bring live performances to our stage. We're unique in the sense that we show films and we do performances. And at the end of the month, we're really excited to have Lopaka Kapanui back. He's a longtime friend of the theater, and he is a renowned ghost storyteller here.
I know him very well.
Yeah, exactly. And so he's gonna bring a different kind of energy mm-hmm. to our space at the end of the month on the 28th, and we're so excited to have him back.
So be prepared to have some fun, watch some film, and be scared all in one.
Yes.
Thank you for having us down. I appreciate it.
Thank you so much, John.
If somebody wants to know a little bit more about the theater, when things are coming up, what's a good site to go to?
They can go to honolulumuseum.org. They can find it through our What's On page or through the theater page, but it's all there.
Well, I expect that if you have anything really exciting that's coming up after the stuff that we just talked about, please let us know so we can let all of them know.
Definitely.
All right,
Sarah,
thank you. Appreciate it.
Thank you.